It is probably a familiar feeling. You're swimming around when suddenly something touches you and stings you, and it doesn't feel nice in the least. Join us, and I will tell you a lot of interesting facts about jellyfish. These jello-like ocean inhabitants appear to have been around for about 580 million years, emerging long before dinosaurs on Earth. Jellyfish are exclusively marine dwellers. Many species choose to live in warm tropical waters or the cold Arctic. Some of them also live in fresh water. Another name for a jellyfish is a medusa or medusa. This is because their round shape and tentacles look like Medusa from Greek mythology, who had snakes for hair. Jellyfish are invertebrates, which means they don't have a backbone. In fact, they have a body without any bones at all. A jellyfish retains a certain shape because its body is permeated with strong muscle fibers. In addition, jellyfish have hydrostatic skeletons. It means that they have the same type of support as a water-filled balloon. They are soft-bodied creatures, consisting of at least 95% of water and a gelatinous mass known as mesoglia. If they wash up on a beach, they'll disappear almost completely as their water evaporates. Jellyfish have no brains. They also have no blood and no heart. They don't even have sides. No left side or right side, no back or front. They have a bell or umbrella-shaped body and trailing tentacles. The tentacles serve as a powerful weapon for capturing prey. On the underside of the bell is an opening, that is its mouth. Jellyfish digest their food very quickly. They wouldn't be able to float on a full stomach. Indigestible particles are expelled back through the mouth. Jellyfish have no lungs and no respiratory system at all. They absorb oxygen through their skin. To move through the water, jellyfish use jet propulsion. Muscles open and close the bell, drawing in water and then forcing it out again to push the jellyfish forward. The color of jellyfish works as camouflage. Most are translucent, which makes them nearly invisible and difficult to see in the darkness. Some species of deep-sea jellies are bright red or orange. Many jellies are bioluminescent. Jellyfish vary in shape. Actually, they look like all sorts of things. There's one species of jellyfish that looks like a neon fried egg, another which looks like Darth Vader, and quite a few that look like party dresses, with endless layers of colorful ruffles. They also come in all sizes. Creeping jellyfish is the smallest species of jellies. It has half a millimeter bell discs with tiny tentacles. These jellies crawl at the bottom of the ocean. The lion's mane jellyfish is the world's largest jellyfish species. It can have tentacles that are over 30 meters long, longer than the blue whale. Jellyfish are effective predators, but they don't actively search for food. They'll grab any prey swimming by with their tentacles. There are tiny stinging cells on the tentacles. Each cell has a tiny bulb that holds venom and a coiled, sharp-tipped tube. When you brush against a tentacle, tiny triggers on its surface release the stingers. The tube penetrates the skin and releases venom. Jellyfish do not attack humans deliberately. Most stings occur when people touch a jellyfish by accident. Even baby jellyfish, the size of a pencil eraser, have the ability to sting. You can also get stung if you step on a jellyfish, even a dead one. But stings from some types of jellyfish can even be deadly. Found in the waters of Australia and known as the box jelly or the sea wasp, it is the most venomous jellyfish. The amount of venom injected is sufficient to cause death within just a few minutes. On the other hand, these stings do not bother such animals as sea turtles, ocean sunfish and tuna, which love to eat jellyfish. Some nudibranchs that feed on jellyfish can ingest their stinging cells and incorporate them into their own bodies, allowing them to sting back predators that go after them. By the way, jellyfish are able to completely restore their bodies. If you cut a jellyfish in half, the pieces can regenerate and turn into two new jellies. The jellyfish life cycle is quite interesting. In order to reproduce, female jellyfish release eggs into the water. Each egg then develops into a free-swimming larva. After a brief period of floating about in surface waters, the larvae settle to the seafloor. There they develop into polyps and begin to feed and grow. Later, the polyps bud into young jellyfish. After a few weeks, the jellyfish float away and grow into mature medusas. There is an immortal jellyfish. These animals can go from being an adult jellyfish right back to being a polyp and start the life cycle again, so they can technically live forever. Jellyfish have been in space. In 1991, some moonfish jellyfish traveled into outer space on the space shuttle Columbia. Scientists wanted to examine how microgravity affected them. The jellyfish multiplied in space. When they came back to Earth, the scientists discovered that the space-born jellyfish couldn't figure out how to deal with gravity. Researchers believe that a human baby, born in space, would have trouble adapting to Earth's gravity too. Next time you swim in the ocean, be careful, but at the same time, do not miss your chance to enjoy the beauty of these remarkable creatures. See you next time!